life and death is a part of farming, obviously, but obviously growing up in the city and my kids growing up in the city, it hasn't been so apparent. The only time my kids have really been faced with actual death of something that they loved was our cat Patron, which they were both very, very close with. So now it's front and center in your faces every day. You know, with the chickens, whether they hatch incorrectly and we've got to feed them to the pigs, or if one of them gets sick in the coop and dies. But this morning we had to feed two deformed chickens to the pigs, and then one that hadn't hatched. So today is an emotional day for all of us. We're also getting rid of the broilers. Yeah. So two of the old roosters that we got from when we bought the property, we're getting rid of today as well.
Which is strong easterly, but one with south and westerly. That's in the afternoon.
Shut up, bro. So obviously that also aids in it, but life and death. We've hatched hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of healthy birds, but it's still a weird kind of feeling. You know, obviously as a farmer we care for animals and care about animals. So, you know, if a lamb dies, which hasn't happened, or a pig dies or something like that, it'll obviously be a much bigger loss than just a couple of chickens, because we kind of have... Flippin' hell. We need to clap a 4x4, yeah. Hello? That the grass is wet and the ground is soft, so I did a little bit of a spin-a-maroo there. As I was saying, obviously a death of a pig or a lamb will be a lot bigger.
It's a historic day for the farm.
The first thing we've produced to start to finish 100% on the farm for our consumption, so this marks quite a big step for us. Yeah, it's a bit of a bittersweet. Obviously this is the first time, so it's a bit emotional, but yeah, I mean this is what we're here to do. So I mean, I think if you didn't feel a little bit weird, then you're weird. But yeah, it's a weird feeling. It's a cool feeling. It's gonna be, I mean, once they're dropped off, I think it'll be a little bit of a weight lifted off my shoulders. Because listen, it's difficult. Never doing this before, and then, you know, managing a bloody 100 of them for the first time, and we were gonna do 1,000. Jeez. Can you imagine? So yeah, we're on our way to Daryl at Nature's Way. He's gonna slag them for us, because we're not really equipped to do that just yet, but maybe in the future. And then he processes them. You tell him how many you want, whole birds or pieces or briar packs or marinated or not marinated, which is an awesome weight off our shoulders, so we can get them packed and we can throw them into the freezer. But yeah, weird, I don't know if the right word is somber, I don't know, but like eerie, not eerie, weird feeling. But yeah, I mean, I'm just gonna sit here like in silence thinking about it for the next 25 minutes while I'm on my way to Daryl. I'll see you when we get there.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, sorry. So the birds come in here. This is the chilled room where they get their time to wait before they get assassinated. Okay. Then stung, bleed, going, then they get plucked in, put into hot water, and then plucked on the plucking machine.
Okay, yeah.
And then they go out onto the rails, which is the invigoration trough. So that's where they gut the chickens and all that. So we'll go outside now. Yeah, so that would be the first stage in, and the rest come in here. They even got boot washers then.
Okay.
That's on plow.
No, you have to, eh? Well, you don't have to, but if you want to be legit, you have to.
Yeah. Okay, so all the things are above the ground at the moment, so you can't really see.
Yeah, it's all good.
So the chickens you'll see later on. They come hanging like that, and then they gut them, clean them, livers, hearts, gizzards, intestines.
Can you separate the livers? My stepdad wants to eat them.
Yeah, that's what we do. It's hearts, livers,
okay,
necks.
You do that. I just eat chicken.
Yeah, yeah.
The rest of the cock, not for me.
Yeah, no. and then it's the cold room, which I built out of old panels lying around on the farm, and then I put a...
Yeah, we got the same now.
Big blower.
Yeah.
Which acts as a freezer or a cold room.
I should have bought a bucket.